Are you ready to check out the new Vokey SM9s? Today I'm at Moulton & Norton Golf Club to meet up with Titleist Vokey club fitter Adam Best. We're going to find out which specs are right for me and what you should be looking for when you're going for a wedge fitting. Right, let's get started.
First, we're going to take a look at bag gapping. Since I got my SM8s, I have put new irons in play, so I've got the T100S now, and these are probably a little bit stronger than what I had in play before, so my pitching wedge is carrying a bit further. I'd say like 120-ish type of play, so I'm not sure if the 50, 54, 58 set is going to be right for me or not. So.
I agree. I think we're going to see this with a lot of sets kind of going forward. It is now with pitch wedge lofts. So we're just going to have to reconfigure that. You might find that 6-degree caps that you currently got is fine, but ideally we'd probably like to see it close down to about 4.
Yeah, I think what I find is that I find it a lot easier to hit like a 3/4 50 than I would a 3/4 pitching wedge.
Yeah.
So in my head, if I went to like a 48 or something like that, I wouldn't mind having a bigger gap between that and say my 54.
Yeah.
Because I don't mind hitting 3/4 shots with them, but I feel like even if I hit a 3/4 shot with this, it still goes like...
Yeah.
My full yard, yeah. So yeah. So first things first, should I just hit a few with my pitch?
Yeah, hit some with yours first. Let's see how far it goes, get a good average of the carry distance, and then we'll move into the gap wedges, determine whether it's a 48 or a 50, and then also which kind of bounce we're looking at.
Yeah.
Generally, kind of divot pattern wise, that is typically what you'd see with this club. So, a good example of what you were saying there in terms of carry distance, 118 average. So, now what we're looking for in terms of gapping, one is ball speed gives an indication. So, we'd look for maybe 5 miles an hour faster, so currently 91 miles an hour. Slower. Because we've got backwards carry distance, we'd be looking 10 to 15 yards less, just to match in with the rest of the set.
Yeah, because I currently find my 50 goes about 100 yards.
Yeah.
So it's quite a big gap. And also, if I get like 100 yards, but it's a little bit further, I know I don't want to be short.
Yeah.
Like it feels like I've got to take a lot off the pitch range to get down to that.
That's it. It's not necessarily a tricky shot to play, but when you do take the speed off the pitch range, the spin drops and everything else, so you can lose that control, so something that you can keep the spin up with.
It doesn't look massively different, does it? But it does look a bit like it sits a bit square. Right?
Yeah.
But then you wouldn't want it to look massively different, do you know what I mean? It's not the kind of club that you'd be like, you wouldn't want them to suddenly change the shape or something. I feel bad getting them muddy, they're literally brand new.
With the basically heat treated, the bottom half of the wedge is where the grooves are heat treated. So don't worry too much about using them too much because of that treatment will last longer. The grooves will stay sharp and spin less.
Let's track it down there then.
Yeah. Yeah,
it sounds
strong, I know what you mean. I'm wondering if maybe the shaft, does the shaft feel heavy? Not really. So what we're seeing from the 48 there, ball speed has dropped a little bit more than what we'd like. It's dropped kind of 8 miles an hour, so that's given us that 100 yard cut, which is not necessarily what we were looking for. We were looking more kind of 110, 105 minimum. So let's explore 46 degree. See if we can squeeze a bit more out of it.
I don't think I ever used a Vokey all black finish.
I was going to ask you actually, any preference on head finish?
Quite nice, actually. It's different because a lot of black wedges are like the face and the toe are kind of different colours.
Yeah.
Whereas this is all the same, so I think that's actually visually like a lot nicer. I think I'd be too worried if I hit one out of the toe on this thing. There'd be like a scratch mark there forever. Like.
Good thing is, you're not going to be hitting it out of bumpers. Well, maybe occasionally. Light, isn't it?
Yeah.
Low speed.
I think it's quite a good thing for people to know if they don't know that, like you can use the bounce to your advantage to change the ball flight.
Definitely.
So obviously having that more bounce is going to bring the ball flight down, which
yeah.
I definitely didn't realise until I had my first flight film a bit, and I was like, what?
Yeah, that's we see it so often with the bounce, and it's something that we go through with the kind of shorter wedges, but you can really change the flight with the bounce. All of a sudden you'll start striking it in the part of the wedge that we want you to strike it in, and that's where you see the guys on too with that kind of low spinny flight. That's exactly what you'll get, striking it slightly lower on the face, kind of 2 to 5 moves up, and that's where you create the spin.
Yeah, and I think that low flight is so important with wedging, because like it just gives you more control of your distance, and especially like in the wind.
It just makes you more consistent, there's no doubt about it. Like you said, your spin rates will be within certain limits, whereas when you start striking it higher up the face, that's when it's almost like a flyer.
Yeah.
Kind of like what you said with the 48 before there, with less bounce, it is going higher because it's coming up higher off the bump face, less spin and harder to judge distance. Okay. Certainly in terms of gap depth, where we want it to be, averaging 107 carry versus 118 in pitch and wedge. What we're going to have to do now is figure out the configuration after that.
Yeah.
And whether we need to kind of rejig some. So you currently use a 50 with 12 degrees bounce.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do, we're going to look at 52s, mm-hmm. just to match in terms of gapping. And we've got two bounce options. Lower bounce 8 degrees, one higher bounce 12, which is kind of what you're used to. We'll start with 12.
Yeah.
We'll check out 8 anyway, just to have a look, see if there's any flight differences, and then we'll go from there.
I think 12 might suit me the most, just because I do have quite a high ball.
Yeah.
So.
We'll see some full shots first, mm-hmm. and then some kind of 3/4, and then some pitches as well. See okay. how the club works.
Cool.
Because what we see there is what we were talking about, that high launch with low spin. Move it back almost like a ball loop. Better that 90. Let's see if you actually would jump straight into the 8.
Okay.
Just to see on those fuller shots. We start really looking at grinds.
Yeah, cool. So my current 58 has 8 bounce and it's an M grind.
Yep.
What other options have we got and what are the differences?
So in the 58 we've got 4 options in terms of bounce and grind. Still keeping the same as SM8, so we've still got the 8M, 10S, 12D and then the 14K. This part of the process, this is the interesting part. This is where we're going to get you to kind of figure it out. We're almost going to do a blind test.
Okay.
So I'm going to give you the wedge. I won't tell you what they are. I want you to hit them, play the shots that you normally hit on the golf course, and tell me how it feels, and obviously we're going to judge the flight and see how it spins and the control you can get. So we'll start off. I won't tell you where to start. Get you on there. Hit that for me. So a few fuller shots first, and then we'll move back some shorter stuff. Really test the grinds.
That spun a lot to say, like, it's pretty wet today.
Yeah. This club, for you, is going to be really important because there is those 6 degree gaps. This is going to cover a lot of shots around the greens, chipping, bunkers, lob shots, and pitches like this. So we've got to get this right. It is important.
To be honest, I do use like my 58 most of the time now anyway. So. Yeah.
I think we can stop there. So how does that feel? It comes off the face,
nice.
Through the turf? Any different to yours?
It feels a bit faster, I don't know why that is. Like, I don't know if it's just because obviously it's a newer face and mine's like pretty warm by this point.
Yeah,
don't look at it. Am I allowed to look
at it? Not yet. So one of the reasons why it might feel a little bit faster is because it has got a little bit more bounce than yours. So it is just kind of riding the turf a little bit more rather than digging in and potentially slowing down. Definitely a lower flight there, isn't it?
Yeah. I feel like I can hit it a bit harder with things together there. But I think that's quite nice because like half shots and three quarter shots are quite hard in general to do.
Yeah.
So like if you can hit it harder, it's nice and feel like you have to hit it really soft, if that makes sense.
Yeah. I think one of the reasons why you feel like that. Any ideas what that wedge was? Which grind? So that's the 14.
Oh.
That's a 14K. I think one of the reasons why you feel like you can hit it hard is because it's spinning so much.
Yeah.
You see how it comes off lower, definitely, but it has a lot more spin up.
Well, the first one, obviously, I'm quite used to like the stand.
Because it's
just the standard bounce.
Yeah.
It obviously felt easy to hit straight away.
Yeah.
Whereas the second one, I had to adjust a bit.
Yeah.
Because it was different, but then I think like it probably was better given like the height.
Yeah. Really impressive.
Is that my one by any chance?
Does it feel like it? Let's try this last one. I'm interested to see this, how this works. It's always worth considering as well where you actually play golf.
Yeah.
If it is one place and the ground's going to be firm. Yeah, so you've got to get somebody that travels well.
Because I play like a lot of national comps, like. You just end up on links all the time.
Yeah.
Which obviously like get really tight lies. Like I would say the only thing with my current setup is sometimes if you get like you're on firm links to it, you've got to hit it over a bunker.
Yeah.
And you've not got that much route. Like I can do it, but I have to hit it like perfect.
Yeah.
This is where you tell me I have to stop.
Why you had to change your 62? Yeah, that could be an option. One that just comes in when you're playing your next golf.
I think that could be an option because, to be honest, when I play links, like it's that window, there's no point having a hybrid.
Yeah.
So you can almost just like take your hybrid out and put an extra wedge in.
Absolutely. For me, they're purely based on this shot alone. I would say either this or the 10, so the two in the middle. But that kind of lends itself to a fuller shot anyway, square face. It'll be interesting to see as we move in and kind of loft some up a little bit, whether that is still the case. I think we can, purely based on what you said, we can rule out the 14. It worked really well. But if you are going to go and play the next golf, or Heathland, or somewhere that's quite firm and bouncy, you need to be able to open it up and loft it. You might not be able to do that with that. But let's check out the course.
Okay, cool.
I've got wet grass, a wet golf ball. I'm going to try
and
flop it.
Shorts iron pin. That's what you're saying, Charlie.
No problem. How do you feel about this shot on the golf course?
I can see that. Probably prefer this stuff. Sure. Yeah.
Good shot. I like that
it's like low and spinning.
So that's
like
interesting.
I don't hit mine normally.
So, spinning a lot, isn't it? It's fizzing up there.
Even with like the. Well, I think some of that would be perfect.
Yeah.
I know, obviously, that's a bit worse.
It skips on.
Things, but yeah.
What about the slightly longer shot there? Just jump into that one.
Same.
Go to, yeah, we'll play a couple of those longer shots and move back to the short one.
I'll take it.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think it does remind you like how important fresh grooves are, because even I know that.
Yeah.
But like I still have wedges that I've been using for 2 years, and like I think I've almost forgotten like how good they were at the start.
Yeah.
This one comes a bit higher, isn't it?
Yeah, it's coming out higher with less spin.
I don't know if that's a visual thing, I feel like I have to open it up more.
It's good, yeah. So yeah, a little bit more balance, just leaving the edge just sitting up a bit too much. I'm just striking it too low.
Yeah, that felt a lot
better. Really good. Would you feel comfortable playing that shot on the course?
Yeah. So the only time I don't feel comfortable playing that is when it's literally like linked to.
Yeah.
But it's because it's so high. Like,
the margin for error is
too. I would go for the first one over that.
Yeah.
Just because I know like it'll get over the trouble and it might run out further, but I'll put.
Yeah. Do that with yours. Well. I think it, for you it is out of these two, it's out of the 58-10 and the 58-8.
Yeah, it definitely feels a little bit easier. Mm-hmm. I don't have to do quite as much with my setup to like get in a position where the bounce is like. Last thing, bunkers, what are you really looking for in between these two options?
Really here, it's got to be something that kind of works through the sand consistently. If we can get that impact with the sand the same more often, it's just going to make your distance control so much easier. Okay. Slightly higher one. So much spin. Okay. Let's try this one.
like I have to hit this a little bit harder on the higher shot to get it to go.
Okay.
I mean, I take either,
to be honest. I think from a consistency.
That was probably, a little bit more consistent. Yeah. But I think it's also quite nice that, like, obviously this is going to stay pretty similar because it's the same as what I had before.
Yeah.
But I've got changes in my other lofts.
Yeah.
So I know, like, I know what's going to happen with this, and it gives me time to adapt to the other ones, I guess.
Exactly, that's it.
Okay, that was definitely pretty interesting, and I think there's a few big things to take away from this. Now, I've gone down to a setup with a 46, a 52 and a 58. Now, the 46 is only 2 degrees weaker than the pitching wedge I've got in my bag, but obviously it is a lot smaller head compared to the T100S, which is why we saw such a big difference in gap in here. So I think it's important to not get too stuck up on having kind of exactly perfect equal gaps between your different wedges, because obviously your pitching wedge is generally quite a bit thicker and has more technology in than your first wedge. So going for something in terms of actual the distance it travels rather than the specific wedge lofting is really important. After that, we've got different grinds and different bounce options to make sure each club suits its purpose. So with me for my 46, I'm going to be pretty much hitting full shots with that. It's for pitching. So we've gone for that F grind and it's got more bounce up at 10, which is going to help me bring that launch down a little bit. Again, with the 52, I've gone for something with a bit more bounce and a bit bigger grind. So we've got the S and 10 degrees of bounce. This is just going to be really good for those kind of full pitch shots and also half pitch shots and just standard chip shots around the green. When it comes to my 58, this is the one that's more versatile. I want to be able to open the club up. I want to be able to hit different shots with it. So we've gone for the M grind, which allows me to manipulate the face a little bit more, and we've gone down to 8 degrees of bounce. Now, as I said in the fitting, I also play a lot of links golf. In this situation, I often take out a hybrid because it flies too high for the course conditions, so it gives me an extra club option. So to fill this gap, we've gone for a 62 with 8 bounce and an M grind. This is just going to allow me to hit those kind of high shots that I need to hit without having to open the face up as much, which is going to really give me those some extra options when the turf is really firm on those links courses. Right, that's all for today. If you have any questions about the wedge fitting process or the new Vokey wedges, feel free to drop them in the comments below. If you're new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications too. And if you're after more golf content, head over to the National Club Golfer social media channels for more.